What is up, everybody, and welcome to a new video. In today's video, I want to talk to you about electronics on motorcycle, and especially I want to talk about riding modes on the motorcycle, IMU systems, safety on the motorcycles. And in my previous video about Tracer 9 lineup, I was talking to you about rider modes which are now available in 9 GT Plus. An idea there is that you will be able to choose between multiple riding modes. And this is not something new, basically. Many manufacturers been using it for a long time, like BMW, Ducatis, Triumph. They all have sort of riding modes, such as rain, road, sport, maybe off-road sometimes, depends on the bike. With the introduction of 9 GT Plus, Yamaha actually gives you possibility to use such rider modes. For those of you who is basically now in the process of choosing the motorcycle, I know that you might be thinking, okay, Tracer 9 GT Plus has much better electronics, or is there a big difference between Tracer 9, Tracer 9 GT and Tracer 9 GT Plus in terms of electronics? 9 GT Plus is more advanced. You ride in the rain and the electronics will do everything for you. Here it's a little bit different. You have 3 parameters which you have to adjust yourself. But based on how you adjust those parameters, you will get your own rider mode, let's say. In Tracer 9, you have D mode, which is responsible for a throttle response. It has 4 stages. Speaking of traction control, there is also 4 modes of traction control. And traction control is responsible for the traction, so it makes sure that your wheels are not spinning. It's responsible for sliding. So when you're going through the corners or through the turns, sometimes your wheels can start to slide. Depends on the road surface, depends on the weather conditions, and depends on how good your tires are, right? They can start to slide, and to make sure they are not sliding, there is a sliding control as a part of traction control. And then you have lift control. So lift control is responsible for controlling your front wheel, because sometimes when you go to the quick acceleration, your front wheel is tend to lift. And to make sure that the front wheel is stay on the ground, because that's where you have the most of the control, the most of the grip, and basically the most of the safety, because when you brake with the front wheel. On this motorcycle, as well as GT, the way how you use traction control or IMU system is you play with, those two modes, and you find which works best for you. On GT version, you also have suspension adjustment. So there are 2 modes for the suspension, A1, which is sport suspension, and A2 is normal or comfort suspension mode, where on GT Plus, it will all come automatically. So you just set the mode and motorcycle will do everything for you. Adjust suspension, adjust D mode, and adjust traction control. So with no further ado, let's jump onto the bike, let's ride, let's see how those modes work together. So now I have D mode 1 and I have traction control 1 as well. So let's go and see how it feels. So D mode 1 means that you have really quick throttle response. But same time, traction control will control absolutely everything. So it's 100% electronics in your ride. Okay. I can feel sporty. Acceleration is really good. I can go through the corners, no problem at all. Beautiful. Nice. So let's stop here for a bit, for a second, and adjust D mode. So again, going back to neutral, and we switch to D mode 2. It means it's kind of like moderate, so that's where I have to feel a little bit of delay in acceleration. So let's see how it works. know, it's still... Yeah, in the beginning. So in the beginning you have a little bit of delay. When you open up, it just slight delay when you open up. But then it goes as it should be. Yeah, not a big difference. Just a little bit safer. But again, traction control still one. So basically you have electronics working for 100%. Yeah. Okay. Let's make a quick stop somewhere here. Just let me see, there is no cars. No cars. Okay. Let me switch to D mode 3. So that's where it should be a little bit soft response. I mean softer response on my shoulder. Yeah, I can feel it. So it's again the second gear, 3000 RPMs. I am open up and there is much longer delay. Yeah, I can feel the difference. Yeah, it's just more user friendly, I would say. If you're new to the bike, if you just like you bought the bike or your first time on this motorcycle, this would be the best mode to try. It's super soft, it's super user friendly, I would say. Exactly. Okay. Yeah, easy to go through the corners. I like it, I like it. I would say it's really safe. But same time, I feel motorcycle very well. Like it. Okay, let's stop here for a sec and adjust our settings once again. Okay. So neutral, and we put D mode 4. So this one should be super soft, but also it limits power output. So yeah, I feel like I'm riding a scooter. I can go through the, let me see, open up. Yeah. And you see, it's not going up in RPMs. So it limits me at 7, maybe 8,000 RPMs. I am quite limited. Open up. And that's it. So I'm quite limited here. Now, okay, let me stop here. Neutral. Okay, now let's put D mode to the first position. Switch to traction control. So now let's play with the traction control. We already tried one, let's go to the second one. So this one should give me a little bit more, say, flexibility. It should let me play with the bike a little bit more. Second gear, third gear. Yeah, I can feel, okay, that's where the difference is. I can feel that my rear wheel is going a little bit off, but it's kind of like controllable off. So it's not that I'm losing it, no.
it goes a little bit, but I can feel how bike controls it. Yeah, I can feel it. I can feel it. Let's try again. Yeah, definitely can feel it. Okay, so let's... Okay, let's stop somewhere here and try to... And now let's switch it off. So what I want to do, go to neutral, traction control, manual. I'm not going to do manual because those are my settings. What I'm going to do instead, just go off. So you hold the up button and it shows you the traction control mode is off. So now, so now let's see how it responds on what I'm doing. Guys, I'm trying to be careful here because as you can see outside temperature is just 5 degrees, which is quite cold, meaning that asphalt is not really warm. Okay, what's happening now is that my trajectory became a little bit more linear. What it means that when you accelerate, I'm losing front, to be honest. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but when I'm accelerating, I'm losing my front. So it's a little bit less control in the front. And that's what I can notice. And my trajectory is not... I mean, the curve of my trajectory is more linear. Because, you know, bike doesn't have that much grip with the road surface. That's why you just cannot, you know, it cannot follow the front wheel, because front wheel is a little bit lifting up. That's what I feel. Okay, let me stop here. Yeah. Okay. And now we're going to initial settings. Okay, TC1. D mode 1. Okay, that's how you can play with those settings, and you can adjust it in a way you like. So you can just, you know, find what is the best combination for you. But also if you have GT version, you will be able to adjust suspension as well, and it can be a little bit more stiff and can be a little bit more comfortable. So in combination with the third parameter, which is suspension, you will be able to, you know, to set your bike even more precisely to find the best balance for you.
So guys, thank you so much for watching this video till the end. I hope it's been helpful. If so, don't forget to subscribe, like this video. And if you have any questions, suggestions, or you want to share your experience, do it in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.